A prolonged drought has forced some into dangerous territory in the search for water. In Hopley, a sprawling, largely informal settlement in southern Harare, community boreholes are running dry. But many have found respite here among the dead. Every day since June, community members have been streaming into this nearby graveyard. The young and the old, plastic containers in hand. After a four-hour wait, it's 15-year-old Monica's turn at the well. The hundreds of people who crisscross the cemetery every day seem unaware of the dangers of contamination from embalming fluids and decomposition. The water from these hand-dug shallow wells is used for everything: laundry, bathing, and even drinking.
When you've got your situation, then you get used to it. People said that in the beginning, that it's near to the graves and that, this and that. But then all of them come and test the water, and it's just like any other water. So then they drink it, no one gets sick.
This is a perfect example of the changing weather patterns. We're told that the water at this national dam used to extend beyond the cattle and even reach up to the trees. But some would say that the water crisis in Zimbabwe is not just about climate change, but it also reflects a leadership failure. The capital's taps only work a few days a week. Some suburbs have had no running water for over 10 years. Michael Chineme is the city's spokesperson.
The city of Harare is in the process of providing piped water to some of these communities.
Water shortages have left people vulnerable not just to disease but also to abuse. Young girls told me their stories, stories in no way linked to the Hopley well owner.
I was in a queue and I was about to fetch water, and then came a man. And then I asked him, why are you putting your buckets in front of mine? And then he said, I need to do what I want. You don't tell me anything. And then he continued saying, if you want to be protected, first date me.
Experts say by the end of the century, climate change will have reduced rainfall in Zimbabwe by up to 20%. The current desperation, a stark warning to the world of what can happen when water sources dry up.